This is Birch in the Woods, and a few days ago I received this very special package, which I've been waiting quite a while for, and I want to show you what's inside. It's not just bubble wrap. So, if you like that sort of thing, I actually did a video quite a while ago called Bubble Wrap Unfiltered, where I do nothing but wrap bubbles. But now, today I'm interested in the content. It's a game. Here, and I think a couple of expansion packs. Mini Rogue, The Depths of Damnation, The Old Gods, and Glittering Treasure. There's also a coaster. Since the print and play version, which was a while ago, so I'm excited to unwrap this and give it a playthrough. So it says, "As the sun sets over the city, the king elected you, a champion, to retrieve the Ogg's blood, a fabled and mysterious artifact rumored to be a ruby gemstone." Description here is, inspired by roguelikes and old-school dungeon crawler video games, Mini Rogue is an engaging solo or two-player game that will immerse you into the depths of the dungeon. Every level is randomly laid out. Each encounter plays out differently, and of course, death is final. Choose from a selection of characters with distinct skills. Use your wits and rely on luck to overcome ever-growing odds. Unravel the mystery behind the Ogg's blood with a campaign mode, or play with a friend using the cooperative rules. And it says 1 to 2 players, 14 years of age. We pass that, and roughly 30 minutes of playtime. Okay, so let's see. It rattles. What could be inside? The Ogg's blood, perhaps. These cards are. These look nice. Well, why don't we open the main one first and exactly appropriate knife instead of scissors. Very, very carefully, so as not to damage the box, only the plastic wrap. Game smell. Okay, so I've got this card, but this must be just a short version. I've got an official rule book here. It's made by Paolo Di Stefano and Gabriel Gendron. They are the game designers. Thank you to all 4,925 backers who made this project possible. I'm proud to be one of them. So it goes over the setup. So we will look at this in more detail when we set up the game, turn sequence, skill checks, combat, feats, effects, potions, items, experience points and levels, character classes and skills, room cards, item cards, monster and boss cards, trap, tomb, bonfire, merchant, treasure card. So, I'm curious to see how much the game has changed or been expanded upon since playing the print and play version. Of course, that was a more simple game. I was still with the same idea, so this is very nice. It's got these custom dice here. Let's open them up and see. Three drop icons and the other ones are blank. We've got, well, regular dice, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and X. That must be bad. That was one kind. Then there's the purple die, the skull, and the black die, which has the 1 instead of the X. Okay, interesting. I'll put them here. The green ones go there, and you go there, and there. Okay, and then we've got these markers. Oh, and nice little custom meeples. I really like that. Simply remember these being the most fiddly in the print and play version, because there were no, I didn't have cubes like this, so I just used scraps of paper to track my health, I think, stuff like that, on this really tiny piece of card, which was kind of fiddly, but this looks very nice. Got different colors and different shapes of the meeple here, some sort of warrior, soldier. looks like a wizard of some kind with a staff, wizard hat. Place them. Oh, can't even see them. Like that. Sorry. Okay, well, I've got a pack of cards here. And these look to be, I was gonna say enemy cards, but I figure there are. Well, let's open them up and see. Should we use the knife here? There. Maybe a bit more. Here. So these are the cards that will make up the dungeon, I think. Just, oh, different here. Okay. Guess I'll place these down here. Down here. And I've got the rogue, the priestess, crusader, mage. Here and oh, what's this one? Double card. Oh. And two more of these combat stances. Interesting. This looks to be a bit more complicated than when I played it last. There are more tokens here. Priestess token. Healing hands. And another hand with a lightning circle of some kind. Curious. Okay. And there's a tracker. Very nice quality. Experience points, XP, armor, HP, health points, food, gold, and different potions here. Then, what's this on the back? Kind of a cheat sheet, maybe. One or two, so that's for cooperative play, but I'll only be playing the single player version tonight, so I'll put the other one aside. Oh, and then I remember this. This looks like the original one, only spruced up a bit. It's the dungeon, and there are your monster health points. First floor, second floor, third floor, fourth floor. Oh, they're different levels. The dungeon and the tower. Oh, okay, that's interesting. Very interesting. Okay. Put that. Available here. Okay, so that was all the main content. Let's see. Okay, so let's just take a peek. These just for the sake of it. I don't think I'll be playing with these tonight. I'll look at them later, but just want to see. And listen to them. against one another instead of cooperatively. Okay. Interesting. I'll put that here. We'll put this one till last. So there's this one, Depths of Damnation expansion pack. Has blessed us with even more plastic to unwrap. And small rule book here. Put that down here. Won't be using this tonight. It would only confuse me. So let us open up the cards. Have a look, see. For this 9-card cosmetic expansion, most of all boss cards and the rewards treasure card with a stunning holographic foil treatment. Sounds so cool. Contents all 8 boss cards from the mini rogue, all gods expansion, and the Depths of Damnation expansion. 1 new rewards. looks like same thing as this one right beside it, except this one is it's different in this puncture tools. Oh, that is very nice. They're the same thing as this one is just way better. So we shall get rid of these. Push them to the side and I'll use these instead. Fix these the same. Place this here. These expansions packs out of the way and the extra quests as well, so we just have the bare necessities. Okay, now let's take a look and see the rules. So object of the game, I think we covered this. You play as an adventurer, delving into dungeon room after room and floor after floor. Og's blood, a fabled and mysterious artifact rumored to be a ruby gemstone, yes. A dungeon area is laid out as grid room cards. Each time you face two rooms, you will have to choose and explore one. You will resolve each encounter by rolling dice, managing resources to pursue the adventure. In each room, you may encounter a monster, find a treasure, discover a resting area, dodge traps, or face many other surprising encounters. The last encounter of a floor is a powerful boss monster that you will have to defeat to continue on to the next floor. You win the game if you can reach the last room of the dungeon and defeat the final boss monster, thus collecting the Og's blood. Setup. So, let us set up. Choose a character. I will. And I will go with the classic rogue, I think. The classic rogue. I will. Yes. Just. Sorry. If that's not shown on the character card, you set it to 0. And I'll move these cubes accordingly during the game. So, HP 10. Place it here. Gold, 5 coins, bars, food. I have 3. That's good. Okay, good. game more challenging. I don't. But if I did, I could start with less health, food, and gold. Okay, place the rewards ghost reference card right in your cabinet. It's this one. Rewards. Ghost. There. Take one dungeon die and one character die. This cube is the Adventurer's Cube. It represents your character's location in the dungeon. To track monsters' HP, put the red cube on the skull icon. Well, there. Okay. Set up the area. Shuffle all the room cards. I'll just get rid of... I don't know what to use these for. There are supposed to be 8 room cards. room guards. The other room guards placed face down to the left of the top left card. Remains boss cards face down. Oh, okay. So there's supposed to be a specific boss card here. Ogs remains face down. Shuffle the remaining bosses and place three of them on top of Ogs remains. All of them face down. From the designers, that's nice. Welcome to Mini Rogue. This passion project started in early 2016, thanks to judicious ideas from Nuts Publishing, the best partners we could hope for. It became a full-fledged game in 2021. It is a dream come true to finally have this game in your hands, and ours too. If you want the best possible experience, lower the lights, put on some dark or eerie music, and turn off your electronics. So, you're welcome to play some dark or eerie music in the background. So, the dungeon mines. Structure is, yes, there are some floors in the dungeon. I think I've got that, and there's some HP character mats. We have several attributes which may never be greater or lower than the values indicated on the mat. Experience points, yes. Armor. Each armor point reduces by one the damage from a monster's attack. And experience points gives me more character dice, which are the white ones. Health. If my HP value ever reaches zero, lose the game. Food rations. Every time your character delves into another area, they'll have to eat, otherwise they starve and lose 3 HP. Gold pieces can be used to purchase stuff, yes. Potions. Maximum 2 potions. May have several effects you may want to use during combat or exploration, yes. You must lose a resource, armor, gold, etc. you do not possess. Lose 1 HP per missing resource instead. Yes, the dice. White dice represent your character's skills. In combat, they determine the damage your character deals. While you start with only one character die, as you delve deeper and deeper, your character gains experience. Additional character dice will be added to your pool. Dungeon die. The black die will be rolled to determine outcomes when resolving various room cards. Poison die, the green die, this one, so it's a poison, not a drop of poison, will be added to your pool of dice when your character becomes poisoned. Oh, I don't want to get poisoned. And the cursed die, I don't want to get cursed either, so won't be needing that, I think. is the one that I have turned over. Treasure. It says, you have a strange... What? You have a strange feeling for a moment. There. The symbols. Okay, so I roll the die. Three. So according to the card, three gives me 5 health points. That's very nice. So I move from 10 to 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. Great way to start. Okay. Once the room card is resolved, reveal the two nearest room cards if possible. The one to your right and the one below the current room. You must now choose which one of these two rooms you'll move on to. Your character can never move diagonally up or left. Okay, so I'm revealing them before entering them. Let's see here. We've got another treasure here. And a trap. Mistaken. It's quite the easy choice, and I think, am I just allowed to go to the treasure then? I'll do that. Yeah, I think so. Okay. Another treasure. And this one says, the lock is no match for a rogue, which is what I am. Roll the die once more, and this says 4. Okay, so this says a green drop slash this eye symbol. So I wonder what that actually means. Okay, let's check in the rule book. Skill check. No, come back. I can choose between two different potions, but I would like to know what the potions are. So the green one is poison. Not the poison. This happens to what? And the eye is blindness. But these are supposed to be good things. And are treasures, right? I think. I'll just read. Okay. So yeah, potions and poisons are not the same thing. So the green potion is a poison, and it allows me to inflict 4 damage on the monster during each of your combat turns, including the present one. And the eye, it's called perception. It says automatically the succeed skill check. Just roll the dungeon die and consult the success result and or cure blindness. Okay. So I think I want the green one. There's no green. Offensive. Maximum 2 potions. Okay, I'll just place this gray cube in this potion. Okay, so I got that now. Good. Okay. Now, I guess I'll remove 2 more cards here and decide where to go. The merchant. And a monster. Okay. So let's see here. Do I go to the merchant and buy something maybe to up my game? I have 5 gold coins. So what can I buy here? I can buy health points. trying to find, refresh your, no. Gain one armor point. Yeah, I'm just trying to see if I can buy spirit or armor or something. So that one is gain a potion, so I can buy a potion. I can buy iron armor. I can also sell armor. Interesting. And I can buy blessing, which allows me to cure poison, a curse, and blindness. I can buy health points. Let me buy some armor. Nice to have, right? It's nice to have. I'll use my 5 gold coins to buy one piece of armor. Okay, good. And I'll move over. Sell them the armor I just bought and get 4 gold coins. That would not be a good deal for me. Okay, and I, after this, I can only go downward to the boss. Oh, look at this boss. The ghoul. The ghoul. Now, so I think the way I'm supposed to read this is one player, first level. 16 health points. He does this complex. 1 damage and 1. Okay. And gives some sort of reward. Okay. So let's read the combat section. Your character attacks first. Great. Then defends themselves against the monster's attack. It's a fight to the death, and whoever loses all their HP horribly. Attack phase. Simultaneously roll the dice pool. This consists of all your available character dice, the dungeon die, and the poison die and curse die, if applicable. I guess it's not. Okay, I'll do that right now. Both the character and the dungeon. Roll them out of here. 5 and 6 for the dungeon. Set aside. No. I now re-roll. No. Perform feats. I don't think I can do that. Or can I? Re-roll. What's the point of a feat? During your attack phase, you may perform feats. The lightning symbol. You may re-roll a character die once. Each re-roll has cost either 1 XP or 2 HP. Let's fight ghoul. So, 5 means I inflict 5 damage. Probably have something to write on. Of course not. I have this one right here. This one says the monster has 16 HP. And does, oh, that was the, okay, I do 5 damage to the monster. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 11. Okay, it says I can also activate my poison here, which inflicts 4 damage, but I'll wait just So the armor I just bought didn't help me anything. Okay, so this one inflicts 1 health damage. So that brings me down to 14. And piercing armor. What's that symbol in the middle there? Let me just check. Table of resolutions. So let's see. Is it here? Is it here? It's not here. Don't know what that means. The game, no. Let me just see. No heart anatomy. Home guards. No. Healing, it's not a poison. Lose any. That must be what it means. Wow, that's tough. So, okay. That updates your pool of character. But I don't have any XP, so I'm level 1. Okay. Okay, so we just. My armor. Ignore armor. Okay. We'll roll again. X. So, I remember reading about that. If your new role, set aside any character die, land it on. So, it's just a miss. No, okay. Well, on the other hand, the ghoul only rolled a 2. So, okay, 2 to 5, its attack is successful. The monster inflicts damage equal to the value on its card, minus your armor points. So, my armor is 1, and it has 1 damage. So, it does not do any damage. Yes, go armor. I'm so glad I bought armor. Now it's a simple matter of rolling again. Okay, 2. So that's the damage I do. 1, 2, and 5. Again, there's no damage. I don't think so. Or does it? Maybe it actually does. Symbol here says to ignore armor. So I guess that's something the boss can do. Okay. So I guess I should lose 1 for the previous one and 1 for this one as well. Yeah, and then a regular monsters like this one, I can use my armor. Okay, so not gonna use my armor for this, but in the future. Oh, a 6. That allows me to re-roll and add to the result. That's awesome. And roll 1. So, cool misses. Great. Okay, so 6 plus 6. Oh my god. 12 plus 5. So 17. And it's actually only got 9 HP points. 8 health points, sorry. The ghoul has been defeated. And I will receive the reward, which is 3 XP. The soul, or okay. 3 XP. treasure. Oh, so that's a treasure. That's a holy potion. Don't know what the holy potion does yet. We should check that. Holy cure your character from all poison, curse, and blindness effects. Okay. That's pretty good, I think. These must be potions. Okay, so I've got this. Got two potions. Now I can carry no more potions. And this level is defeated. And now we'll move on to the next level. Still on the first floor though. Okay. And turn, you'll explore an area comprised of 8 rooms, and you'll delve deeper to the next area. Okay, so I do delve to the second area. Okay, I consume 1 food ration. Now I have 2 left. Flip my character card face up. If it's face down, it's not. Move your adventure's cube. Yes, I did that. Roll on the cards. Reveal or not. Add them to the unused. These. That's strange. The dungeon map, the card area, crimson or gold, skull icon. Reveal the top postcard. Oh, maybe the dungeon map. The current area has crimson or gold skull icon. Well, I did the first one. Top boss card. Oh, so I actually faced the boss card too soon. I didn't have to do that. That was weird. Can that be true? I think it is. not revealed, and it's just an exit. So I'll just remove it now, way over there, and for the next 2 months I won't. I'll just use this as an exit. Okay, so there are 10 areas, and we'll play through them all. Okay, so there's the first one. This log is no match for rogue. No, it is not. And I roll a 4, which means I get to receive either a potion, which I, oh, that's too bad. I should have used my potion in the boss fight, because I already have 2. Resolve the treasure cards, you'll find gold pieces. Okay, so I do find gold pieces no matter what. Here I find 1 gold piece, or I find 2 hearts, or health points. Can that be right? Wow. Apparently my eyesight is worse than I thought. Corridor and a shrine. Oh, very interesting. The shrine looks interesting. I'll go there. Say your prayers, wanderer. Spirit. This has +2 hearts, so gain 1-2 XP's, HP, I guess. And this golden eye. Not an eye, but yeah, starry eye. cards. Oh, so you probably read this. Shrine cards. What profanities the corruptors of this altar did, no one will ever know. Maybe an offering will steer the gods in your favor. Okay. So our Solemn Shrine card, roll the dungeon down, consult the table. Before rolling, you may make an offering of one gold piece to modify the die roll by anyone. I didn't do that. Once you've made the offering, the plus one modifier. This is a giant spider, actually, not a goblin warrior, as depicted. Okay, so I'm level 2, and he's got, the giant spider's got 6 health. I'm level 2. Okay, but I will inflict 2, and I'll also use my poison against him. Solve an item card, look at the icon when it's better. If you meet the conditions. I don't know what that means. Oh god. You can take the item and put it next to your character card. Oh, okay. The player may only carry you. Okay. To resolve the crow card, feed with the crow with one food ration or ignore it. It will steal one gold from you. You should feed the crow, take its card, and will remain by your side until you use one of its skills in exchange for another item. I need another example. I need the armor example. I don't know what that icon is. Is that gold? Hmm.
Is it gold? No, it is not. Skill check. Okay, I did that. Where did I? Did not. I'll look up skill check. Combat. Skill checks. While luck may sometimes favor the inexperienced, experts prevail even in dire situations, it says. Shows a star icon. Okay. Did not. Okay, so this was not successful. So I ignore it. Okay. And move on to the exit. I'll delve again. And lose one food. Okay. So next look for some food. And do I do anything else? I don't. I don't think so. Okay. And the cards. So this has 9 health. Let's start by recording that. Let's see, this is, was this a blessing or what? Just checking to see if I can use my potions for something. Let's see, what was it? This was the goblet, the holy cure from poison cursed plants. Okay, so I'll use that later. The skeleton soldier all the way down to 0 and say watching, and it turns into dust. Go to dust, young man or woman, skeleton. Okay, and I will receive 2 experience points, not 2, and I'm now at level 2 rogue, which means I receive another tomb can be both good and bad. I'm gonna see some treasures in there, but also some negative stuff. Mostly positive. But the crow is interesting. example. The rule book. The treasure card. Item cards, right? Feed the crow with them. And we'll steal one. Okay, so like that. Okay, so that's what it means. Okay. Oh, but I need food. I can't give the crow my food. I need the food. Yeah, sorry, crow. I'll move here. Okay, roll the dice. The die. Two. A ration. Excellent. A ration of food. Excellent. Okay, that's it. Check. Okay. If successfully, may modify the result of the dungeon die roll by +1 or -2. Okay. So, roll, and if any of them have a star, they don't. God. Okay. So So, nothing here. Nothing. Respite now and then, for death could come at any time. Sharpening the blade helps you focus. When resting at a bonfire, if your character card is face down, flip it face up to mark the skills available again. Stop. Then choose only one of the available actions on the card and update your stats. Okay, so I can get experience points, I can get food. Always use food, rests, well rested, with HP. Sorry, just thought of a song there. HP. I'll take the food. Stock up on that. Also classified as a tomb card. So here I must perform a skill check. And no. So 5. The mushroom is a so-called glowing cap. Oh, and I receive 2 XP. Excellent shroom. And I will now go here, and since I'm not at the boss level yet, I will not reveal this one. I'll just delve instead and remove one food, or consume one food. And spiked floor. Oh no. Let's actually see. I think I have to do a skill check and not just roll. Yeah, perform a skill check. Okay, good. Oh, and I succeed in the skill check, so I'm going to modify it to 2. Plus 1 or minus 1. I think. No. If the skill check is successful, it is an reward in the success column corresponding to the dungeon title. Oh, awesome. So, I actually, instead of poison spikes making me lose 1 HP and poisoned, I gain 1 XP. So I just jump right over the poison spikes. I spot them with my roguish falcon eyes. Okay, and reveal the next. Oh, bonfire. Great. I love the bonfire. I'll go to the bonfire. And I choose one. Okay, I just got food. So should I hone my weapon? Food, perhaps. It's tricky because you need the food, but you also need the weapons. I'll take the food. I don't know. Yeah, I like that. Okay. Damn cave again. The tomb. Okay, I had success with the cave last time. Food and battling a ghost with 12 health points, which could take health points from me but also give me HP or XP. Ghost in the tomb. 12 health points. There. Good. I just need to roll 2 6s. No big deal. I did not. I rolled 2 3s, 5. 1 2 3 4 5. And the ghost rolled 4. So he attacks with 2. He attacks with some sort of a poison 2. Just check that. Poison or curse. Okay. and 2 health points. No, 1 point because of my armor. Okay. I'd rather lose health than experience, though. Okay. Okay, now I really need to just slay this ghost. Cure poison, curse of plants. I've already got a blessing to do that, though. Yeah, I guess I'll take it. Take the blessing. How do I write that down? Blessing token. Do I have that? I don't think so. I'll just make up that. I'll make believe like this is the blessing. Something or 2 gold. I'll take 2 gold. You can always use some gold. I'd rather have experience, but can't have everything. Okay, I will now delve deeper. Lose some food. Reset the dungeon. I wonder. rest. That was my stomach. My stomach wants to search for food apparently, but I will choose to hone my weapon. Yes. Seems there's something particular about the bonfire. No. I'll hone my weapon and gain one experience point because I want to get to level 3 as quickly as possible. So we can get another. Shrine or treasure? I'll take the treasure. Okay. So I get one gold. I think let me just study this closer. Plus two. I'll check, or do I just get to keep keep it? Yes. If successful, you must take the rule corresponding to touch die. Or choose one of the two options, if applicable. One. Oh, if you've encountered any monsters or traps in this area? Well, I haven't. Okay, now it's about a gold piece instead of indicated on the card. Okay. Skill check. Perform a skill check. If successful, you must then take the reward corresponding to the dungeon die or choose one of the two options. Okay, so I didn't succeed. So I'll only get the gold. And reveal, okay. Tomb and corridor. Let's see. So I'll take the tomb again. I'll take the tomb. I'll do the skill check here. Six is a dotted cap, which gives me the green poison, which is useful, but I'd rather have experience. 15 experience points. When I get 18 experience points, I get to level 3. Okay. And that was it. Now I delve again. Lose one food and reset the dungeon. I'm now in area 6, third floor. And bonfire. I'll do the bonfire. And I'll hold my weapon. Now I'm only one experience points away. So what I'm dealing with here is an undead arbalist with a health of 12, damage of 6. That is mean. That is very, very mean. Man. Okay. Give me experience, but you know what? I'll take my chances with the trap and hope that I'm roguish enough to avoid it. I was not. So this is for a thick web. I lose one armor. But blinded or something. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I am blinded, but I have this potion here, so I'll just get rid of that. Oh, I also have the blessing. That was the blessing token. I'll just get rid of the blindness cure. Is that what it's called? You've entered it. Yeah. Well, I don't want that. So, I will. Another trip. Great. Let's see. Yes, I succeed. So, the warrens will give me 2 gold coins. Yes, I have 5 gold coins now. And this one I will not reveal because we're not yet. End of the catacombs. I'll just consume some food, delve to the 7th area. If I roll 1, 2, 3, then I'm cursed. So, and if not, I get stuff. Okay. I'll make an offering of gold, sure. And then just roll this die here. 5. Okay. And then, then it's a 6. Okay, so. Gain 1 HP, so that's fine. Let's see what else we have here. The damp cave once more, and the bonfire. Oh lord. Well, the bonfire is good. It's actually especially good now because I get to hone my weapon and move up to level 3. We'll do this one here. the six here. The bats swarm the cave. Gives me 2 experience points. Great. And the next card here is also a trip. Okay. Well, now I've got 3 character dice to roll with, so all the better chance of surviving the trap and actually getting something out of it, and I do with the 6. So success, and it's 3 of the maze. Gives me 3 gold coins. 1, 2, 3. A total of 7 coins. Oh, and I should reveal this. The king's protector. Level 3, so he has a health point of 20. That's cool. 6 damage. And I have exactly 12. So he only has to hit me once. Oh, twice. Okay, let's see. It's not possible to defeat him. 7. 9. Okay, that's good. That's fine. I reduce him to 11 points. And, oh, and he misses. He rolled a 1. See that? He rolled a 1. A 1. So he misses. Excellent. I get to roll again. Oh. 3, 3, 6. So that's a 10. Okay. And he's got 1 left, but he does have a critical hit. So he ignores my non-existing armor. That's 6 damage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. And I get to roll again. Okay, I missed by 2 of my dice hit. I missed. And the remaining one, it was a 2, but luckily he only has 1 health point left. So I defeat the king's protector anyway. And receive 3. Experience points. Okay, so I didn't actually have to hone my weapon all that much, because the monsters and the enemies give me a lot more experience. But well, anyway, I'm there now. Wouldn't have survived without 3 dice there, and I get a nice reward. Let me see. 1. So that is either the fire potion or 2 experience points. And by now the experience points translate to health points. So let's see if what the fire potion does. Inflict 7 damage on the monster. I want that. Yes, please. Okay, very good, very good. Now the king's protector, delve deeper into the sunken keep. Oh, and now I have 0 food left, so that means I have to get some food in this level before I delve, otherwise I lose 3 health points, which at this point is quite critical. I'm not going to survive meeting any monsters in the 4th floor with only 3 health points, because they get progressively stronger, stronger, and stronger the further down you get. So we start with a trip. Well, of course we do. Fine. Okay, I will because I have 7 gold pieces, so I can buy quite a lot of things. Let's see. I can buy, that's weird, that staircase symbol there. Potion of my choice. A potion costs 5 gold coins, and that's quite expensive. Frost, the monster does not attack this turn. Oh, that could be quite useful. Because I don't need the experience anymore, or the gold coins. I just want to get by without getting hurt. So I'll go to the empty shelter. Do a skill check. And I pass, it's a success, so I get to 6. Adventurer's Ghost. Okay. Okay, so I was going to meet a ghost here, which is bad, but instead I get to fall into the rogue's trap and only lose 3 HP, so I guess I'll do that. Oh, rogue's trap. Yeah, and move along, delve, lose food, reset the dungeon. Now in the night, so that's very bad. I will I haven't been cursed yet, so I don't know what happens or how bad that is. Okay, that's pretty bad. So maybe we should save that if I do get cursed. Okay, so. Okay, I'll visit the fighter shelter then. One food. I don't have any food left, so I'll lose 3 HP instead. 1, 2, 3. I'm now down to 14. Delve deeper. So this is actually the final area of the sunken keep and the dungeon. Holy potion. It cures my curse immediately. So. Merchant or corridor. Well, I can buy 1 HP from the merchant. Yeah, I'll do that. Don't have anything else to do with my gold. here I can lose. I'll go to the shelter and hope for. Cleric shelter allows me either a holy potion or a healing potion, but I can see that Og remains here. Poison and curse me every turn. So that's pretty bad. So I think maybe the blessing potion is more worth it. Here, I'll take that. Okay. And move on to Og's remains. This is phase one, phase two. He's got different. Phase two, this phase one. I guess so. Or phase two. I don't know. We'll call this phase one. And Og's remains as 25 hit points. There we go. I have 3 attacks with 8. Exactly what the curse does. Add the curse time to your pool of character dice. Or cursed. Whenever your character dice roll lands on a curse symbol. When this happens, subtract 1 from each of your character dice. Okay. Oh. But I actually have a holy potion here, so I'll just cure it. Remains is dead and gone. Why is it that you were so drawn to this gemstone? Do you still remember why you came to this dungeon in the first place? Well. Very, very interesting. That was the end of the game. Surprisingly, I survived until the end. I thought it would be a bit harder. Maybe I was just lucky this time. And don't know that I exactly understood.